Welcome back. This video will show how to use the graphing calculator to determine points of intersection. Let's first take a look at two linear equations. One thing about using the graphing calculator, the equations do have to be solved for y. So this first equation is in the appropriate form, but the second equation is going to have to be solved for y. So let's go ahead and subtract 2x on both sides. So we'd have 3y equals negative 2x minus 12. We'll divide everything by 3. So our second linear equation solved for y is going to be y equals negative 2/3 x minus 4. Now these lines are in the form where we can enter them into the graphing calculator. So let's go ahead and get our graphing calculators out. Go ahead and press y equals. So y1 will equal 5x minus 21. And y2 will equal negative 2/3 x minus 4. We really should put our fractional slope in a set of parentheses. Now let's go ahead and press graph. And if we find the point of intersection on the screen, that's good news. If we don't, we would have to adjust the window. So this is the point of intersection here. Let's go ahead and press second trace. Option 5. And now it's going to ask three questions. It's going to ask for the first curve, the second curve, and then for a guess. If we only have two graphs on the screen at one time, we can just go ahead and press enter for the first curve, enter for the second curve. And when it asks for you to guess, you can go ahead and just press enter again. And we can see the point of intersection is the point 3, negative 6. Remember, this value for x and y would represent the solution to this system of equations. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more. Notice the first equation is solved for y again, but notice this time it is a quadratic equation. So we'll have the graph of a parabola, and then our second equation is a line, so we'll have a parabola and a line, but we do have to solve this equation for y. So we'll go ahead and subtract 4x on both sides. So we have negative y equals negative 4x minus 1. And we'll divide everything by negative 1. That'll just change the sign of everything. So we'll have y equals 4x plus 1 for our second equation. Let's go back to our calculator. Press y equals. Let's clear these out. y1 will be x squared plus 1. y2 will be 4x plus 1. Let's go ahead and press graph. Now, for some reason, if your calculator did not have the standard window, remember you can always just press zoom 6. That'll switch it back to the standard window. Notice on this graph, we can only see this point of intersection, and this point of intersection is off the screen. So we are going to have to adjust the window. Since we want to see higher on this graph, we're going to increase the y maximum. So let's press window. Let's change the y maximum to 20 and see if that's high enough. Press graph. And there's our parabola. There's our line. We have a point of intersection here. And now we see the second point of intersection on the right. Now the calculator can only find one point of intersection at a time. So let's go ahead and press second trace. Option 5. Notice the cursor is blinking very close to this point of intersection. So let's go ahead and find this point of intersection first. So let's press enter 3 times. And the first point of intersection will be the point 0, 1. Let's go ahead and record that. So to find the second point of intersection, we'll have to press second trace again, option 5. But before we press enter now, we have to move this cursor closer to the second point of intersection. So if we press the right arrow, the cursor will move to the right until we're closer to this point of intersection, somewhere in there. And now we can press enter 3 times. And the second point of intersection is the point 4, 17. And again, these points of intersection would represent the solution to this system of equations. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.